do the review.
You have to. It's for a grade.
I don't care. I'll take a 0 this week. I am not reviewing this movie.
Come on, don't be all like that.
No, no, I'm not doing it. You're stuck. No, 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 I'm sorry. No,
I don't want to.
No, 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 no.
This is Norman North. Okay, so after companies like Disney and DreamWorks had big hits with 3D animated films, they've pretty much revolutionized the genre as a whole. Not only did they practically wipe out 2D animated films, but they dominated kids' films, becoming the most successful animation studios in film. But every now and then, a new company can come along and surprise you. Illumination Studios, for example, despite being an unknown name, had a big hit with the Despicable Me movies. And so other companies like Splash Entertainment thought they had enough talent to break out from just producing TV shows and try their hand in a motion picture. They were mistaken. This honestly might be one of the worst animated films I've ever seen, period. It's supposed to be about a polar bear in the Arctic who can speak to humans and becomes famous in New York and tries to teach the message of protecting the environment. Instead, it teaches them the message of why you don't go to see films made by the same people responsible for the Bratz movies. I mean, what kind of monster would create an atrocity this horrendous? Who would be so evil as to poison our minds with this bullshit?
Oh, I can't do that.
Who are you?
Oh, glad you asked. I'm Monica Mother the Bear, the shining star of my very own video game, Danganronpa. Available on Amazon for $29.99. Bye now, bitches.
Oh. Oh, well, I know you. You're from that weird video game where everybody bleeds Pepto-Bismol for some reason.
Yep. My dream is a world filled with despair. Buildings burning, families torn apart, a world arriving in bloody pain and agony. That's why I made this movie! So everyone lose hope and suffer till death, and you are going to watch it with me!
Goody.
Oh!
First of all, take a look at this stellar animation. My god, Pixar should just bow in shame. What are those things? Well, this is quite the eyesore. Prepare yourselves, everybody. We get to look at this for a whole hour.
Hour and a half.
Shoot me. So after those vomit-inducing visuals, we're introduced to our main hero.
Don't listen to the haters, Norm. You're a polar bear. You got this.
I personally thought the bear was a good choice of animal.
He's voiced by Rob Schneider. We're starting off on a high note here, folks. This is Norm, a polar bear who's next in line to be king of the Arctic. He also has a bland, generic love interest, embarrassingly obvious mini rip-off sidekicks, and he completely sucks at hunting. Clearly, he's fit for the job. We also see a bunch of humans wanting to explore the Arctic, since they're unbelievably stupid, apparently. Whoa, look, snow! I've never seen that before! Norm seems to finally catch up with the seal, but can't bring himself to kill it over its irresistible puppy dog eyes.
You want to know why I'm not going to eat you? You got a minute? Well, maybe an hour. It all started when I turned 13.
What's going on? He's talking to human. What?
I didn't know what to do.
Move any farther and you will taste the wrath of my spear blades.
No other bears seem to be able to speak human. So I went to go see the wisest bear in the world. The king of the Arctic. Who conveniently was also my grandpa.
I'm glad that I now know the backstory of this polar bear. It'll add a lot to his character development. Oh no, wait, no it won't because I don't care. So we see Norm talking to his grandfather, who explains that talking to humans is some sort of inherited trait of the leaders of the Arctic or something.
Our land is vulnerable, and we're responsible. For now, just know that what you and I have is a great gift.
Look, Simba, everything the light touches is our kingdom.
That's the only movie you rip off in this, right?
Be afraid.
But when will I understand? But it didn't end there. human tendencies had taken over my body.
No song. No song. Please stop. Please stop. No, please. So because the pacing in this film is non-existent, we immediately cut to Norm overlooking the Northern Lights and having a deep conversation with his brother, who I'm assuming is on meth.
But I made some money off your failed hunt today, big bro. Au contraire, mon frère.
And unlike Norm, his brother doesn't seem suspicious of the humans coming into the Arctic.
The humans won't destroy something they love. And they love us.
Never show that image again. I mean, Jesus, that's just nightmare fuel. So Norm, literally 1 second after saying he'll never perform for the humans, performs for the humans. Because, hey, we gotta pad this movie out somehow. Soon after, Norm finds the most poorly designed evil headquarters building ever. And discovers a shocking secret.
Humans are moving here? To live?
Oh yes, that makes perfect sense! I mean, who wouldn't want to live in the Arctic? I mean, there's so much to do around there, like... freeze to death? Yeah, that's about it. Seriously, speaking as a New Englander, it's bad enough up here, guys! Norm tries to warn the others, but nobody believes him.
I can't even stand for myself.
Norm, don't listen to them. They're just furry robots sitting in their ice cubicles obeying the rules, pretending nothing bad's ever gonna happen. But you can change the rules. You're seeing the future. They're just living in the past. You can find a new way.
Is she in this movie for a reason?
You mean other than to be the generic love interest?
Yeah.
No.
Norm also stumbles upon what seems to be a group of people filming the equivalent of a Geico commercial, except minus the humor. So you know, a typical Geico commercial. When he gets an idea on how to defend his home. I feel like this plan is going to end in hijinks or a very bloody homicide. We also see a woman named Vera, who works for the real estate company selling houses in the Arctic, talking to her daughter named Olympia, who spends her time making blatantly obvious commentary.
But what will it look like when you, Mr. Green, build all those houses there? You're changing the Arctic. Change isn't always good.
No, I feel like this movie is to environment protection, where crazy social justice warriors are to feminism. Nobody's even gonna take your cause seriously anymore because of you. Hope you're proud of yourselves. So Norm and his tiny hairball demon set out to destroy the filming equipment.
Okay, that one was a coincidence, I swear.
Cute and cuddly, boys. Cute and cuddly.
Vera, a director always delivers and never quits.
There goes the footage.
I quit!
So after that, we cut to, oh, Jesus.
Good job today, Lemmings. But let's not get too comfortable.
Yep, see, somebody in the audience just killed themselves. Nice job, everybody. We also see Vera chatting with her boss with an obviously ironic last name, Mr. Green. By the way, how the hell do they get such good reception in the Arctic? And of course, Green's a typical corporate hack villain with no likability whatsoever.
The floor plans for your condo in the Bahamas are already on the way. It's so gigantic, it's bigger than my ego.
Subtlety at its finest.
Oh, Mr. Green, the director quit!
What?
Okay, how are you gonna fix this? How are you gonna fix your fault?
Well, I've been filming all day. And I got some really great footage of a polar bear that almost attacked me.
You've been filming. That is so cute. I'm sure you think you're a regular Scorsese, all right? I need something people might actually want to watch.
Oh, you mean like literally anything other than this movie?
Wait a tick. I love it. This bear is a star.
I just love his nose. So Vera has to find an actor that looks exactly like a polar bear. Makes sense to me. Giving Norm the idea to hitch a ride in a conveniently portable house and follow her to New York so he can become the spokes bear for the real estate company. Gee, a wild animal traveling to New York and becoming famous? That doesn't sound familiar. So this was your idea of destroying the world, making a shitty ripoff of Madagascar with polar bears?
Oh, it's much more effective than you think. Plus, I guarantee the next 5 seconds will make you want to smash your head against the desk.
But what are you talking about?
Whoopsie doodles.
I hate you. One pointless musical number later, we cut the next morning where we see Norman is Norman Furballs that he brought for literally no reason have arrived in New York overnight. I'm calling bullshit on that. So he's taken to Green's headquarters and quickly caught by two guards. Luckily for Norm, he manages to escape into the city because clearly no one would ever notice a giant bear running around on the streets.
Okay, bad costume, but he knows the way to Green.
Why the fuck would he know the way to Green's? It's just a guy in a bear costume. And what are you trying to escape from, Greens? What the hell's going on?
There he is!
I think we can take him!
Hey, patron girl, you want some popcorn?
Take him with you. Take him with you, please! Please, he's gonna kill me! No! No, don't let me! No! Don't let me! Don't let me out of winter!
So you're here for the Green Holmes audition. King of the Arctic, I take it?
Yeah. Use the Arctic to sell the Arctic. It makes sense.
Well, you certainly look the part of a bear. That costume is exquisite.
Oh, yeah, how original. The guy thinks the animal he's talking to is just wearing a costume. Never seen that one before. Meanwhile, Green seems to be talking to the only sensible people in this movie who present him with the totally ridiculous idea that maybe, just maybe, selling homes in the Arctic is really fucking stupid.
People aren't interested in living in the Arctic. Know how I know? Because that graph shows you're currently at a 3% approval rating. Until that number gets above 85%, not approved.
We then cut to Norm entering the building where...
Sign in and wait over there, Travolta.
Hey guys, toilet's right there. Help yourselves.
Oh, look, the thing! It's fine.
No, it's not.
It's still going. Are you laughing now?
No, this is not funny. This is just gross. Why are you really funny? They're just peeing. What is funny about that? It's nasty. No, you need to stop. This is just gross. Like, what the hell is wrong with you? Stop it. You need to stop. Stop it! So after Green threatens Fear with the worst arm animation ever witnessed by man, Norm wins him over and convinces him to let him help sell the Arctic.
Norm is just a consummate actor.
Yeah, that's pretty bad when you're trying to pass off Rob Schneider as a good actor.
And he even brought Arctic lemmings.
Is it funny now?
No! So after Norm and Vera leave, Green starts to suspect that maybe, just maybe, Norm might actually be a real bear.
The only thing that looks like a bear, sounds like a bear, and smells as bad as a bear is a bear.
It turns out that this bear is actually Norm's grandfather, who Green captured and is keeping in a locked cell for reasons, and he's afraid that Norm will try to break him out or something. Meanwhile, Norm and V are eating lunch in a sushi restaurant. Oh, wait a minute! A bear in a sushi restaurant? I smell shenanigans! I'm in hell. Oh yeah, and I guess there's some kind of subplot, but Olympia wanted to get into a top-notch school.
A lot going on?
Yeah, sorry about that. Olympia is, well, brilliant, but it's complicated.
Yeah, because the one thing a film about a talking polar bear needs is added drama.
Good schools are important.
Yes, really, really, really important.
By the way, what would a wild polar bear know about schools?
You wanna play rough?
But Green busts in and tries to shoot Norm with a tranquilizer dart.
Don't worry, patrons. It's just a tranquilizer gun. It's only sometimes lethal on humans.
Oh, can you shoot me? Can you shoot me? I'm right over here. See, can you shoot me here? Right here, please, please. Please.
Ah!
Oh. Is there a sharp pain in everyone's bottom?
Is it just me?
Okay, was it just your goal to rip off every scene from Madagascar?
Stop or your punishment will be most severe.
Oh yeah, what could you possibly do to- Okay, fine, I'll stop! Just don't show that again! Afterwards, we find out that the approval ratings are actually going up after the whole shooting incident.
Because of me, your ratings just jumped 20%.
Oh yeah, a real estate company represented by an obnoxious talking bear run by a crazy homicidal maniac selling houses in the Arctic that literally no sane person would ever want? Sign me up! But Norm starts to suspect foul play and spies on Green.
Sorry to wake you, but I found an actor who plays a polar bear perfectly. The public will fall for him for sure.
Smart! They'll love him, especially all those extra tourists we let in the Arctic.
Just for you, Green.
You want 10 miles of ice? We still have 5 million more!
You motherfuckers! We'll show you that it's not okay to invade other people's property by invading your property! Wait, that seems a little backwards.
Okay, think. If you were a slightly creepy one-note villain, where would you keep stuff hidden?
Hey guys, it's the director here. That probably just sounded like a terrible joke right there, but, We actually just wrote that to inform you that we pretty much just gave up at this point. We know our characters are horribly written, but, we don't give a shit. So, feel free to continue watching if you want, but just know that it will cost you your sanity. We still got 40 minutes left, guys. It's your choice. Okay. Still want to keep watching? Alright. See your funeral.
You guys go check it out first. If Grandpa's actually in there, tell him Norm has come to the rescue.
Yes, they're dead! Ooh. Aww.
Oh, you didn't think I'd kill off our adorable lemmings that easily, did ya? They look great in all of our iPhone app advertisements. I still got problems I can make off this stuff. Bring in the moolah, baby! Huh?
So the lemmings find Norm's grandfather, leading Norm to come up with his master plan.
Oh, no, he wants me to focus on the Arctic. Saving the Arctic.
Oh, you mean that thing you were already doing? So Norm ends up going on some sort of talk show where... Oh my god, would you stop with the musical numbers? There's only so much physical abuse I can take! By the way, do any of these people have jobs? Even though Bear Jesus is won over the people of New York, Green's boss still isn't satisfied.
I can't get this through until Norm publicly says Norm of the North supports Green homes in the Arctic.
What sense does that make? People already know he represents the company. Why does he have to say out loud that he supports it? That's like requiring Ronald McDonald to say every McDonald's out that he doesn't think Chicken McNuggets taste like cardboard. You'd think that would kind of go without saying.
Hey, come on, we don't need to watch kids' movies. We have bears in funny outfits.
Yeah, okay, that doesn't make up for a lack of a coherent story.
Just shut your trap and sacrifice your sanity already.
So Norm finally gets a promotion where he plans to reveal his opposition to Green Homes. Which probably wouldn't do jack shit at this point. But if you haven't figured out by now the only thing motivating these writers is their paycheck, please seek help.
Okay, lemmings, we got one shot at this.
This film makes me want to hurt someone. So Norm tries to explain that building homes in the Arctic would harm the environment, but his plan is ruined by a diabolical Mr. Green.
Norm of the North supports Green homes in the Arctic.
Wait, couldn't he just say that he doesn't support it afterwards? Why is he stopping? Why does it matter that his microphone got cut off? Hello? Hello?
Your announcement has been reposted a million times!
No, your announcement was reposted a million times. I had something I needed to say.
Oh, okay, you know, we're gonna fix this problem, okay? You know what we're gonna do? You know, you got phones, you got cameras, why don't you just film yourself and post it on YouTube? I mean, that shit'll go viral in like 2 seconds. But no, instead we get the sad character cliche where he sits on the park bench and a bus splashes him with water and all that. But Vera invites Norma over for dinner, where we see Olympia has been an interesting discovery.
Anyway, Mommy, I was researching the effects of human activity in the Arctic, and the research is irrefutable. It will destroy the Arctic.
Really? Building homes in the Arctic is bad for the Arctic. What? I didn't know that. Did you know that? I didn't know that. Wow, I mean, this girl really must be a genius if she can figure out what anybody with common sense could figure out. But just then, Vera finds out that the company got approval to build the homes.
We're in. We got approval.
Oh, so I guess I failed. Well, that sucks. They tried. Movie's over. Bye.
It's not over yet, Norm.
The hell did you just say?
Hit Mr. Green where it hurts. His wallet.
No, the movie's still going?
Oh, don't worry. It only gets worse.
How much worse could it possibly get?
Did somebody say racially insensitive stereotype?
No! Nobody said that!
Well, too bad. We're doing it anyway.
I am Pablo, and this is my investment group.
Oh, well, that, yeah, real classy, guys. So Norm reveals that he's a real polar bear to the investors who don't even question that they're talking to a living abomination of nature. Oh, am I kidding? This whole movie's an abomination of nature. So after blowing the investors off, Green decides Norm's crossed the line.
Commence operation. Kill that bear.
Wait, you're killing the one thing that can promote your business? You know what? I don't even care, okay? I'm done applying logic in this movie. Let's just get this over with. So Norm breaks his grandpa out of the cage, and the two of them try to stop the ships from delivering the homes to the Arctic. But things go awry when an old nemesis returns. Oh, okay, you know what, I'll make this easy for you guys this time. And died. The end! Okay, sorry that didn't actually happen. I just really want this movie to be over. So instead of showing the audience mercy and killing the bears off, these assassins instead tie them up in the back of a helicopter and then try to shoot them because reasons. But it turns out that Norman's grandpa have a brilliant escape plan.
Wait, you guys think we're bears?
Talking polar bears in Manhattan, and come on, guys.
Yeah, maybe our friend the Easter Bunny's around here, too.
Are you sure they're bears? They sound like humans to me. I didn't sign up to shoot real people.
Okay, Norm and his grandpa fall into the ocean, but Norm can't untie his grandpa. And then they drown, the end. Oh, son of a bitch!
Norm, no matter what happens, just know that I'm proud of you. You've come a long way. You might think you're not a hunter, but you are.
Oh yeah, his hunting, that was a thing, right? Meanwhile, Vera quits her job, the investors do something, I don't even know, and Norm and his grandpa try to stop the boats. It's a miracle! Yeah, remember all these characters that you developed no emotional connection to? Okay, so he's really dead this time, right? Right? Okay.
What your tears of despair give me power!
Okay, that's it! I'm finishing this! So after Norm wakes up out of nowhere, he finds himself stranded in the middle of the ocean where he belongs. Back in New York, people who literally yesterday loved Green now turn on him because I guess their minds are like frickin' light switches that can just turn one way or the other.
Ha! Look who's out of hibernation!
Wait a minute. What? How did he get back to the Arctic? What, did he just swim a couple hundreds of thousands of miles?
I march to the beat of my own drum. You know that.
Yeah, hello? I'm still waiting for my answer. Hello? Oh, so you're not even gonna give me an explanation?
Hmm.
Well, I suppose we could come up with a bullshit excuse. Okay, how about this? It turns out that there was a secret wormhole in the ocean that brought them back to the Arctic, they thought was left by aliens, but was actually future polar bears who developed the ability to time travel and help them out.
Isn't that the twist from Interstellar?
Look, punk, you want an answer that's as good as it gets!
But it isn't all sunshine and rainbows, for not only were we forced to witness this travesty upon mankind disguised as a movie, but Norm was also faced with some sad, sad news.
Where's Grandpa? Did he?
We've searched everywhere, Norm.
Yeah, he comes back.
You can't do this without me.
Grandpa!
Oh, you guessed my big twist!
A chopped tomato could have guessed that. So everyone lives happily fucking ever after, and the bird Socrates says the only logical sentence spoken in this movie.
You need therapy.
Oh, trust me, we all need therapy after this movie.
I wonder if Vera and Olympia can see this too.
Whoa! They're beautiful.
It's the circle of life. This movie is shit.
And that was Norm the North. Thank God it's over. This movie is just atrocious. The fact that it was ever released in theaters is completely baffling to me, considering that it has the quality of a cheap direct-to-DVD movie you pick up for $5 at Walmart hoping it'll entertain your kids for an hour and a half. Hell, it's even lacking on those standards. The animation sucks, the voice acting is lame, the plot is recycled from a dozen other movies. There is not a second of it worth watching.
Yes, does this mean you have finally given in? Have you succumbed to despair?
No, of course not.
Aww.
Even with the amount of poorly made, lazy, and half-assed kids films, I know that there are always going to be people out there who are going to try their hardest to make good animated movies. Not because they have to, but because they want to. Because they have something unique that they want to express about the world. So you can make all the terrible movies you want, but it won't change my faith in all the creative people out there who are willing to put their all into their work.
No, I will crush you until you succumb to despair.
Oh yeah, and how are you gonna do that?
I've got a time bomb in me! Oh, I'm set to explode in 30 seconds!
Ah!
There is nowhere you can run, nowhere you can hide, nowhere to- You know, in hindsight, I probably should have seen that coming. Oh my god, am I still falling? You know, I'm pretty sure I should have exploded by now. Oh no, wait, there we go.
I'm Pinktwingirl and I'm getting out of here.